In the fictional South Florida port town of Blue Bay, 18-year-old spoiled rich girl Marie Clifton is expected to receive two stunning diamonds known as the mother and daughter. However, the manager prohibits them from getting close to her. Jay Clifton, Marie's stepfather, challenges the will, alleging that he believes Marie is not ready for the responsibility and instead wishes to claim the diamonds for himself. This leads her to threaten her stepfather. After that, she drives away in her sports car, coasting along Blue Bay, while one of the students traverses rivers using a swamp boat. Arriving at Blue Bay High School, she almost bumps into this student named Elena Sandoval. Although she apologizes, Marie does not accept the apology, and they part equally bitterly. Marie, together with her friend Jenny Bellamy, discusses her inheritance. Jenny advises her to get a lawyer, but Marie insists that it costs money and that Jay is not the type of man to mess with. As spring break approaches, Principal Phillips is forced to tackle the subject of sex education, which makes the students excited, except for Elena. During the lecture, Dr. Chad Johnson, who runs the forensic lab at the police department, explains that reports of unwanted pregnancies are up to 16%. While he is talking, the girls notice his attractiveness. They also notice something on Elena's leg, which Marie explains is because she's under juvenile probation. Kristen Richards, a probation officer in the Juvenile Department of Corrections, discusses her harrowing personal experience in her high school years. Kristen admits that she was a victim who forced by an unidentified suspect many years ago. This leads the whole room into silence. All she can remember is him whispering in her ear, "You won't remember, but you'll never forget." At Marie's swim meet, she performs well and does her best. However, Jay isn't impressed, citing, "Nice takeoff, but work on your landing." Jay meets Elena Sandoval, an unpopular poor girl from the school. He asks her why she didn't join the competition. Elena insists that it's a sport for rich girls and that she is tasked with folding the towels as part of her probation. He now thinks she's been a bad girl. A while later, Jay invites her to a party he has prepared for Marie, which puzzles her. At Marie's party, Jay walked around and saw two men who seemed to want to make a deal with him. When Marie wanted to find him, a man threw her into the pool, causing her to slap him. While she was looking for Jay, she noticed him talking to two men, who apparently owed him money for his construction business, and they threatened him. Marie wanted to check it, but he ignored her. Meanwhile, Elena arrived at the party, and upon seeing her, Marie seemed disappointed knowing that she hadn't invited her. Marie attacked her and threw her into the pool. While the two were having a commotion, Jay came to separate them and took Elena's side, insisting that he was the one who invited her. Due to Marie speaking badly, Jay was forced to stop the party. Later, at the construction site, Elena arrived to meet Jay. He ordered her to remove her wet clothes, which made her uncomfortable. The next day, when Jay returned home, Marie immediately spoke to him to apologize for causing trouble to Elena. Then, Detective Michael Morrison arrived to arrest him for attacking Elena, and he insisted on his innocence. At the police station, Morrison wondered what Kristen was doing there, and the two seemed to have a past. Detective Morrison talked to Elena and reminded her how serious her accusation against Jay was and that it could lead to a thorough process of investigation. But she insisted that her accusation was true. Morrison reminded her how influential the man she accusing was. During the physical examination, Julie ordered Elena to remove her clothes, and she found a scratch on her chest, prompting Chad to take a picture. At the construction site, Morrison doesn't believe Elena's accusations, which contradicts Kristen's belief as the probation officer handling Elena's case and as a victim of the same crime. Chad investigates the crime scene and finds some evidence that may be relevant to the case. During the hearing, Chad testifies in court, showing some evidence he believes supports Elena's accusations against the defendant. In the shower room, Elena notices Marie's ring without a diamond, but Marie catches her. Marie tells her that she won't get anything, not even a dime from Jay, prompting Elena to quickly leave. On the other hand, Detective Morrison receives a CD from an unidentified sender containing a video of Jay talking to Elena during Marie's swim meet. This video is shown in court. Jay insists that he only offered Elena a job, but the court does not believe him. Morrison comes out of the courtroom to tell Marie that her stepfather is in a lot of trouble, which prompts her to threaten Elena. Despite Jay's reluctance to see her, Marie comes to support and comfort him. Marie feels that Elena is doing this for money, knowing that she lives in a trailer park, and she instructs Jay to find her price and pay her. Jay explains that he is broke, and Marie proposes that they sell the diamonds. Jay agrees, and he asks his lawyer Theo Bloom how it could be done. Theo advises them that he has a buyer, but only if the Diamonds have a clear title of inheritance, prompting Jay to give it to Marie. Later, Elena receives a call from Marie advising her to come over to her house to talk about something. Elena later travels to Marie's place, where she meets Marie showing her inheritance title, which makes both girls delighted. It is revealed that the two have a relationship, and they are eager to entertain each other. As things heat up, Chad arrives and wants to join in, and the three heat up the whole mansion. The next day, in court, Elena claims Jay not only took advantage of her but also threatened to get rid of her if she informed anyone. Jay whispered in her ear, "You won't remember, but you'll never forget," which exasperated Jay, insisting on his innocence. Kristen, on the other hand, now suspects Elena is lying. Elena cites a phrase Kristen's suspect told her the night he took advantage of her. Kristen informs Detective Michael Morrison, but Morrison states that it could be a coincidence and that all the evidence points to Jay's guilt. Despite their contradictions, they agree to investigate. That night, Kristen and Morrison explore Elena's trailer house. Since the door was closed, Kristen broke it down forcefully. After entering the house, she notices the ring, and discovering that Elena has been compiling details on Kristen's case, citing that Elena stole her life. The next day, Marie observed the beauty of the gems that Elena thought she would leave at the bank. But the doctor already found a buyer. After a brief chat, they heated the room once again. At the detention center, Morrison and Kristen visited Jay to gather some information. They discovered that Marie was the mastermind behind offering money to Elena and that Marie might have had an accomplice to obtain the diamonds, which Jay quickly realized. They proved that the girls might have worked together to set up Jay. Using her swamp boat, Elena traveled home. Upon arrival, she noticed that there had been a forced entry into her trailer house. Because of this, she immediately went to her accomplice Marie to inform her that their strategy had been foiled. She thought that her probation officer might have entered her house. However, Marie calmed her down, telling her there was nothing to worry about. They entertained each other once again. At school, the cops talked to Marie to gather information. Kristen noticed Marie's ring, which might have been waiting for the right stone. Marie was accused of collaborating with Elena, with the help of the doctor, to set up her stepfather to force him to give up the challenge of the will. But Marie admitted nothing, except that the diamonds were hers and not Jay's. Chad was questioned by Richards and Morrison and feared they suspected him. Kristen examined a photo of the scratch on Elena's chest, which Chad claimed was made by fingernails. However, Kristen thought it might have been made with the ring missing its stone. Chad admitted nothing, though he was worried. Because of this, he immediately met with Marie and gave her a drink. However, Chad became anxious and wanted to see the diamond. Though Marie was reluctant, Chad convinced her to get it and let him examine the jewels. Soon after, Marie felt dizzy from the drink, which had a sleeping substance. When Marie passed out, Chad immediately called the buyer to sell the diamonds. Afterwards, she immediately called Elena to inform her of what happened. Elena quickly chased after Chad, trying to make him pull over. Meanwhile, Marie arrived to intercept Chad, causing him to lose control and fall off a cliff. The two girls pursued him into the woods. However, they encountered a problem since Elena was not allowed to go more than 10 miles away from the police department. Marie realized that Kristen would find out Elena's location because of her ankle monitoring, which could send a signal to Kristen. Soon, Chad caught Elena, and the two grappled with each other, giving Marie an opportunity to eventually capture him and get rid of him with a tire iron. After grabbing the diamond, Marie ordered Elena to get rid of the body in the car, and Elena complied. Marie then traveled on her way to meet the buyer Chad had arranged. When the buyer checked the diamonds, they discovered they were fake. Meanwhile, Elena remained in the woods, where she was apprehended by her probation officer Kristen and Detective Morrison. At the station, Elena insisted that what happened was an accident, but she wasn't believed. Kristen and Morrison offered Elena a deal and a perilous task. If Marie admitted she slayed Chad, Elena's fraud charges would be reduced. Elena agreed and immediately called Marie, convincing her that the police had released her. Marie mentioned that the diamonds were fake and instructed Elena to come to her house, which witnessed by the cops. After being equipped with a wireless microphone, Elena went to Marie's house. There, Marie revealed that the real diamonds were at a construction site, information she obtained from Theo. While the cops listened, Elena tried to get Marie to confess, but she didn't succeed. In detention, Marie and Elena negotiated with Jay for the combination to the safe in exchange for Elena's confession letter that would clear him, and Jay agreed. During the trip, Elena tried to get Marie to confess, but she was still unsuccessful. At the construction site, the girls went to fetch the diamonds, with the investigator listening via wire, and Elena took out her side arm, grabbed the diamonds, and left with them. While Marie chased after Elena, Kristen rushed in and shot Marie in the chest, which caused her demise. After the chaos, Kristen promised to take Elena to the station the next day, and Elena also confirmed that they did not find any diamonds in the safe. The next day, Kristen did not show up, and it was discovered that the evidence in the locker was missing, apparently accessed using Morrison's key card. Morrison is left alone to consider being duped by another dangerous woman for the second time. At the end of the film, it is revealed that Kristen and Elena are mother and daughter, relaxing with Jay. Later, Richards narrates what happened in 1988, stating that Jay took advantage of her that night, resulting in Elena being born. The disoriented Jay, due to the drinks, remembers nothing. The mother and daughter say, "You won't remember, but you'll never forget." After falling off the cliff, he is told, "Nice takeoff, gotta work on the landing." Let's delve into the untold events. At the construction site, Kristen approached Jay. Knowing that Jay wouldn't win against Marie in court, she planned to take Marie out of the picture. In the shower room, the lovers Marie and Elena discuss the diamond and plan to set up Jay. Marie talked to Chad to collaborate on the plan. While they were looking for Chad, Elena deliberately sent a signal to her mother. While having fun, Kristen took Morrison's key card. In the last scene, it is revealed that Theo Bloom is the buyer of the diamonds. For more videos similar to this, don't forget to subscribe and enable notifications. Thank you for watching.